الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. So today, بإذن الله تعالى, we begin our next story. And our next story is called Al-Ghurab Wal-Hayya. Al-Ghurab Wal-Hayya. Now, as you can see, I haven't written the vowel on the ba or on the ta marbuta. And the reason why I haven't written the vowel on it is because it is.
It's our job to say it.
Yes, that's good, mashallah. It's your job. So, animal haqqa, what goes on the ba? Good. Al-Ghurabu. And why is it Al-Ghurabu? What's the reason for it?
Nidafa. We're looking at Nidafa too. We're looking at two nouns?
Yeah, we have two nouns.
So the one of the rules is that in the first word.
Just wait. Is that an idafa al ghurab wa al hayya?
No. It's not connected. Wa mean an. Oh. He and you. So it's not connected. So what is that? It's not going to be Ghurabun because that's
right. Right, it's not going to be Ghurabun because we have Al, the Lam al-Ta'rif, the. But remember, that's not an Idafa. An Idafa never has a wall between them. So what is on the Tamarbuta here?
Same.
The same, which is?
Al-Hayyatu.
Good. Right? And why is it Al-Ghurabu Wal-Hayyatu? What's the reason for it being Al-Ghurabu Wal-Hayyatu? What state is that?
Both marfu'un.
Both marfu'un, good. And why is it marfu'un? Because?
Dhamma.
Yes, that's the indicator that it's marfu'un. But what's the reason why it's marfu'un?
No, it's because it's a default state.
Good, that's the point. That's what you should know, Abdullah, remember? Right? No, this is straightforward.
Yeah.
Right? Al-Ghurabu is going to be Al-Ghurabu in the default state because it's just a one, nothing's acting upon it, right? There's no reason to change it. So it's going to be Al-Ghurabu Wal-Hayyatu. Okay? We know this, right, Abdullah?
Yes.
Right, now, Al-Ghurabu means?
The raven.
The raven. Okay. Wal-Hayyatu means?
The snake.
Okay. And the, well, yes. Wal-Hayyatu, good. And the snake, right? Now, before we carry on, we've mentioned Al-Ghurabun frequently, right? We mention it. And sometimes, some people, they question, well, what's the purpose of learning that word, Ghurabun? Okay, what benefit does it give you? Well, the benefit is that there is an ayah in Al-Quran in which Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ غُرَابٌ يَبْحَثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ فِي الْأَرْضِ in Surah Al-Ma'idah فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ, right? Remember now, we start فَبَعَثَ. فَبَعَثَ is what type of word? فِعْلٌ, good. And what do we always say when a فِعْلٌ begins with fa?
So, it's an addition, it's not part of the verb.
But it might be.
Alright.
It might be, remember, if we say فَهِمَ,
then is part of the verb.
For him, the fa is part of the verb. It means he understood. Okay, so it's not always that it's an addition, right? But here, for ba'atha, what does it mean? What does the fa mean here?
So.
So. How do we know the fa means so in this ayah?
Because the fi'l and three of them in there.
Because the fi'l is? Ba'atha. Ba'atha. What does ba'atha mean?
He searched.
Not he searched. Oh. Close. He?
Found.
Not he found. He sent. He sent. Ba'atha means he sent. Right. So if ba'atha means he sent, who is the fa'ilun? Oh. Abdul Hamid. Who's the fa'ilun?
Allah.
Allah Azza wa Jalla is the fa'ilun. And therefore Allah is, what status Allah in?
Marfu'un.
Marfu'un. With, and the indicator for marfu'un is?
Dhamma.
Dhamma. Good. So what does it mean up to this point? فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ.
Allah sent.
Good. Allah sent. So here we have a classical jumlatul fi'liya, don't we? Right? Why? Because what is the third portion or the part of a jumlatul fi'liya?
Mafulun.
The mafulun bihi. What's a mafulun bihi here?
Ghuraban.
So that word ghuraban is mentioned in Al Quran. And what state is ghuraban?
Mansubun.
And the indicator for being mansubun is?
To fatha in the tongue.
Well, it doesn't matter if it's two, but the fatha indicates that it is mansubun. So the meaning of this statement, Abdul Hamid, is?
Allah sent a raven.
Allah sent a raven. Okay? Yabhathu. What did he say? Yabhathu means bahatha. We've done that word bahatha, that fi'lun, in Tajirul Hadid wa Jar. Bahatha means
found.
What happens before you find something?
You search.
Right. Yabhathu. That's what bahatha normally means. Okay? Searching. But here it doesn't mean searching. Why? I'll explain in a moment. Fi, what type of word is fi?
In
harfu jar, and al ard, what goes on the dad?
Ardi.
Why?
Because
Because it's majrurun. And the indicator of it being majrurun is?
Kasra.
The kasra. That's the indicator. Fil ard. So the meaning of that ayah is, so Allah sent a raven, yabhathu fil ard. Now normally, in translations of Al-Qur'an, they translate yabhathu as searching. So Allah sent a ghuraban searching in the earth. But it doesn't mean searching. It means yahfuru. Yahfuru means to dig. Right? It means to dig in the ard, in the earth. Why did Allah Azza wa Jalla send a raven to dig in the earth? This is a tafsir question, but no. Yes, Abdullah, yes. Right, because when Qabil killed Habil, and that was the first killing in Al-Islam or in the history of mankind, he didn't know what to do with the body and it was left. So Allah Azza wa Jalla sent a raven in order to dig in the earth. And there are different explanations of what happened, whether Allah sent two ravens and one killed the other, whether the one raven was already dead and Allah sent another to bury it. Whatever it is, there's a difference. But the point is that Allah sent a ghuraban to dig in the earth that would then show the older of the two sons, the elder, what to do with his brother's body. Okay, so whenever you read that ayah or you hear it, now you know the meaning, right?
So how have you gone from he searched to he dug?
Because it's another meaning of bahatha. Yahfuru is another meaning. Just like a word can have more than one meaning, then here it has another. It's the lesser known meaning, but that's the meaning. Okay, is that clear? Fine. So that ayah is in Surah Al-Ma'idah. So, Wal-Hayyatu. Al-Hayyatu means a snake. Okay? And this word, is that mentioned in Al-Quran? Yes. Where? In what context? In?
I'm looking for the distribution.
No, in Surah Taha, when Allah Azza wa Jalla addressed Musa alayhi salam, and he said, "Wama tilka biyaminika ya Musa." He said, "O Musa, what is in your right hand?" When he first addressed him, "Qala hiya saya atawakka'u alayha wa ahushu biha ala ghanami wa liya fiha ma'arib ukhra." He said, "It is my staff, my stick. I rest upon it, I lean upon it. Wa ahushu, wa ahushu." Hasha means to take a stick. This is what shepherds used to do. And they used to wave it in a tree in order that the leaves fall down so their animals can eat it. So he said, alayhi salam, that I lean upon it and I use it to bring leaves down from the trees. وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَعْرِبُ أُخْرَى. And it has other purposes. So then Allah Azza wa Jalla said, أَلْقِيهَا يَا مُوسَى. So Allah said to Musa alayhi salam, throw it down. فَأَلْقَاهَا. So he threw it. And then what happened? فَإِذَا هِيَ فَإِذَا هِيَ فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ حَيَّةٌ تَسْعَى. فَإِذَا so هِيَ حَيَّةٌ. What does هِيَ حَيَّةٌ mean?
It's snake.
What does هِيَ mean?
It
for
female.
A female. It for a female. فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ تَسْعَى. تَسْعَى means moving quickly. Why is it تَسْعَى and not يَسْعَى or نَسْعَى or أَسْعَى?
It's a female.
Shabazz?
She.
Right, she. تَسْعَى is she. How do we say he? He moved quickly.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We moved quickly.
Nasa.
Nasa. I moved quickly.
Asa.
Asa. In the. Right. So, Hayyatun is mentioned in Surah Taha. Okay? So, that is the title Al Ghurabu Wal Hayya. So, Animal Haq, read the first sentence, please. Right, Kana Gurab.
Kana Gurab Yaishu
Yaishu. Ya ay shu fi
shajarati.
Fi shajarati. Fi
shajarati.
Right. We're going to put the vowels on there. Sakallahu khair. Right. We've got kana ghurab. So, Abdullah. What goes on the bar? Ahsan, what goes on the ba?
Dhamma.
One or two?
One.
You want to put a single dhamma on ghurabu?
No, actually two, sorry.
Why two?
It's default.
Default state. See, Abdullah, it's a default state. Just a normal ismun. Right? The default state is with two dhammas, there's no alif lam preceding it. So it's going to be gurabun.
Yes.
Right? Yes. Okay. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Right, so kana gurabun ya'ishu. Okay? So ya'ishu means
lived.
Not lived.
He lives.
Ya'ishu. Let's put the wrong vowel on. Ya'ishu means he lives. Okay? Kana gurabun ya'ishu. Okay? Ya'ishu means he lives. How do we say she lives?
Ta'ishu.
How do you say we live?
Na'ishu.
Good. How do you say I live?
Aishu.
Aishu. Aishu. Right? Aishu. Ta'ishu. Ta'ishu. Ya'ishu. We have to get used to. Every time we see a verb, whether it's the past or the present, we should ask ourselves, so how do we conjugate it for the other person, right? That's what we should do. And then inshallah, after a while, it will become easy because it's the same.
Yeah.
Isn't it? The beginning is the same. It doesn't change, right? Kana gurabun ya'ishu. So, ya'ishu means he lives. But when we have kana preceding it, what happens to the time period? It becomes?
Past tense.
Past tense.
He used to live.
Right? Kana gurabun ya'ishu. So we know that bit. We should have mastered that now.
No. We just read it.
Right. Good. We should have mastered
that's why,
that.
That's why Abdul Hamid said he's reading the wrong story. Because that's the first line of
right. Okay, so we should know this now, inshallah. Okay? Right, Abdullah? Then we have fi. Fi we know is what type of word? Fi.
Harfu
jarrin, a preposition. We don't need to use preposition anymore now, do we? Because we know harfu jar. Okay? Fi. Then we have ash-shajara. What does ash-shajara mean?
Tree.
Ash-shajara. Okay? And a shajara, what goes on the tamarabuta ya ahsanu?
One
kasra. Fi shajarati. Okay, now we need to remember another term now because we're becoming more advanced now, mashallah. Right? Whenever we see a harfu jar, and following it is an ismun, like a shajara, and it becomes a shajarati. That's called al-jaru. Al-jaru. Okay. Al-jaru. So the harfu jar is referred to as al-jaru. Meaning the thing that's making it majrur. And the thing that's become al-majrur is called al-majrur. Al-jaru wal-majrur. Majrur. So we know this term anyway, right? Al-jaru wal-majrur. Okay? So fi is a harfu jar, but you know when you're analyzing it grammatically, you say, oh yeah, that's al-jaru and that's al-majrur. Okay? Right, that's not particularly complicated, inshallah. Right. So our first sentence, therefore, kana gurabun ya'ishu fi shajarati. So Abdul Hamid, brother, what does that mean?
The gurab is to live in a tree.
Say it again.
A gurab. Used to live in a tree.
Good, I like that. A gurabun used to live in the tree.
In the tree, sorry.
And also, because we now know the word for gurabun, we don't need to keep translating it to raven, do we?
No.
We know this now. And the more words that we know for certainty, that's how we should refer to them rather than the English. Right? كان غراب يعيش في الشجرة. Why? Shabazz, brother, the next sentence. Well, just try and we'll write it down, then we'll add them. What?
وبا قلبي من شجرة جهرة.
Repeat it.
Sorry, وبل غرابي من
من
من شجرة والشجرة من الشجرة جهرة جهرة حية.
Right. So the next portion. Wabil qurba. Wabil qurb. That means and close by. And bil qurbi, close by. Okay? Yes. From al qarib. Okay?
Story from before.
Now it begins with a ba. And a ba is what type of harfu jarrin? So what's going to be on the ba in al qurb? Wabil qurbi. Wabil qurbi. And close by. Okay? Yes. Wabil qurbi min. What does min mean?
From.
Right. And what type of word is min? Harfu jarrin. Good. Right. Now, what we have to do, if, remember what the rule is with regards to pronunciation. How are you going to pronounce min and a shajara? Minash, minash. Why? Because you can't have two sukoons meeting.
No.
There's a sukoon on there, and there's a sukoon on there.
So what okay? Minash. Minash.
Yeah, so that becomes a fatha.
Minash.
Becomes a fatha. But as you know, because sheen is from harufu shamsiyah, from the sun letters, you don't pronounce the lam anyway.
Yeah.
So it becomes minash shajara t. Good. Minash shajara t. Okay, wabil qurbi min ash-shajara t. What does that mean? An mulhaq wabil qurbi min ash-shajara t.
And nearby a tree.
From
a tree. From the tree.
From the tree. And bil qurbi, close by, min ash-shajara t, from the tree. Which tree is it talking about, Abdullah? The tree that the Ghuraban lives in. Okay, it's important that we remember the meaning in addition to its grammar. وَبِالْ قُرْبِ مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ, the same tree that the Ghuraban kana yaishu, used to live in. Okay, so close by مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ جُحْرُ حَيَّ. What does جُحْرُ mean?
Hole.
A hole, as in a hole in the ground. Hayya, hayya. What does that mean, Abdullah? It's in the title.
A snake.
So what does juhru hayya mean?
Snake hole.
A snake's hole. A snake's hole. Okay? Sorry?
There's no possessive character on the snake.
That's because we're going to write it.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Right? Yeah. So, جُحْرُ حَيَّ. What type of construct is that?
Yeah.
Abdul Hamid? A snake's hole? What does that construct give rise to? What does it relate to? Two nouns?
Two nouns. Together.
Related to one another? One of them refers to something that something else owns or possesses. Idafa. Or idafatun, if we're going to pronounce the ending. Right. So, in an idafa, what are the rules regarding the idafa? What goes on the ra here? What goes on the ra?
Dhamma.
A dhamma. Right? So in an idafa, the first noun, remember, it can only have one vowel. It only takes one vowel. But it can be in any of the three states, right? Why is it juhru here? Why is it in the marfu'un state here?
Default,
good. Remember, don't change the state of the ismun unless there's a reason to. If you don't know what the state is, leave it as a marfu'un. There's no need to change it. Okay? So it's juhru. What the second noun, ismun, and in idafa is always? It's always majrurun. It's always majrurun. So what goes on the ta marbuta here? How many?
Just one.
At Shabazz, why are you going to place one kasra on hayya?
I thought that was this part of the rules that it was only just one.
No. On the first, yeah. On the mudafun. Yeah. But the mudafun ilayhi can be?
Two or?
One, depending on?
Al.
Yeah. Depending on what, Abdul Hamid? Al. Is the al on hayya?
No.
So it's going to be?
Two.
Good. Why? So, jihru hayyatin. Jihru hayyatin. What does jihru hayyatin mean?
Snake hole.
A snake's hole. Okay, a snake's hole. So what does it mean up to this point, this sentence, Shabazz?
Well, isn't it just, it's still a snake hole. It's not a snake's hole. It's not his hole.
It is, because that's what an idafa does. It gives you the meaning of possession. It is. It's a snake's hole. It could be anybody's hole. It could be a boy's hole if you said juhru waladin. It could be your hole if you said juhru shabaza. It could be anybody's hole.
So I don't need to look for the possessive character for these two nouns. We're not looking for who or ha. Because that's possession, isn't it?
Yeah, but the possessor's here. The second noun.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
I'm not sure what you mean by the who or the ha. So you don't need a who or a ha here. Who and ha are attached pronouns, remember. We don't need an attached pronoun here because we've already got the object, the possession, and we've got the possessor, hayyatin. Right? Dalla? What? Yes, Abdullah, you can.
He had any mic.
You can watch the video. You can catch a lot of
your hair. Right? So going back to this point here, juhru hayyatin. Shabazz, you understand what we're saying?
Yeah, so do we only need this possessive character if it's a verb or something?
I'm not sure what you mean by possessive character. Right, so for example, if we wanted to refer to, right, hayyatun, let's say we wanted to say her whole.
Yeah.
We would say juhru ha. Juhru ha. Is that what you mean?
Yeah.
Juhru ha.
That means, yeah. Juhru, that's her hole. Yeah.
That's her hole.
Yeah.
That ha,
yeah,
refers back to now hayyatun.
Yeah. Oh, right.
But the problem with juhru ha, if that was by itself, it wouldn't tell you whose hole it is, just her hole. Right?
Right.
You understand? Or its hole.
Yeah.
If ha refers to an inanimate object. But here we don't need that, because here we're specifying who the possessor is. Right? Dal Hamid? Can you see the difference in Juhru Hayatin and Juhruha?
Yeah.
Right. Ahsan? Right. So Ahsan, what does it mean up to this point? Wabil Qurbi.
And close by from the tree. A snake's hole.
Right. So what it means is, it's close by, min ash-shajarati, is juhru hayyatin. Juhru hayyatin.
That's what I'm
doing.
Okay, we got that.
Yeah.
Right? Then we have this word, soda. What does soda mean? What does soda?
No.
Have we done so, black good accent? Now, colors, we may as well mention something about colors. Colors in Arabic can be male and female. right? So, soda is black if it's describing a female thing. Aswadu. Aswadu is black if it's describing a male thing. Okay? Or we say it's mudhakkarun, that's male. Sawda'u is mu'annathun, right? Sawda'u and aswadu. And now that I've told you that, what does sawda mean in this portion of the sentence? What does it mean?
Female.
Yeah, we know soda is female, but so, all right. So what does it mean here? We know juhru hayatin means a snake's hole. So when we add soda to it, what does it refer to?
A black snake's hole.
Good. A black snake's hole. But how do we know it doesn't mean a black hole of a snake? Right? Because it could do, couldn't it?
No.
You could say a black hole of a snake, or you can say a black snake's hole. Which of the two is it here? And the fact that I've already told you the difference between soda and aswadu, you should know.
Yeah, because soda is female and hayati is tamaruta.
So good, animal haq. Remember,
you have to repeat that again, too fast.
Right, say it again, animal haq.
Because the hayya is a female one, because end of
yeah.
That soda is gonna be referred to female one. Soda is a female one.
Remember, when you have nouns and adjectives, they must agree
each other
with each other in four matters. One of them is in gender. So if your ismun is male,
has to be male.
Your adjective, your sifatun, has to be male. And if your ismun is female, then your adjective has to be female. So you know now from here that soda can only refer to which one of these two, can only describe one of them. Which one, Abdul Hamid? Hayyatun. It can't describe juhru, can it? Because juhru is?
Whole.
Whole and whole, what type of gender is it? Male or female?
Male.
Male. And therefore we would use aswad.
So aswad
will
be at the end.
Yes.
Instead of...
Soda. Now, we all understand that, right?
Yeah.
So the next issue, therefore, is what ending goes on the Hamza here? Is it soda'u, soda'a, or soda'i? Or and is it soda'un, soda'an, or soda'in? Think about one of the rules of agreement between your ismun and your sifatun, or your mawsoof on the thing you're describing in your sifatun. What's it going to be?
I thought they had to be the same.
Which is?
So it would be two kasras.
Good.
They have to match
with
that.
They have to match.
Yeah,
so right. Now you're going to be really confused.
Oh, no.
Right. But before I say that, right, I'm going to give you another example. Right? Baytu al waladi al kabir. Right? What does Baytul Waladi mean?
The boy's house.
Good, excellent. The boy's house. What type of construct is it?
Idafatun.
Good. So now, if we want to say a large boy's house, a large boy's house, what do we put on the ra?
You have to link it to the boy.
So therefore, what ending do we have?
Kasra.
Excellent.
So many is coming, it's going to be the same.
Why?
The 2, 3, 4 coming the same.
No.
That's right.
Okay. Is that clear, Abdul Hamid?
I think so. No, right.
So remember what we said. Baytul Waladi means?
The boy's house.
The boy's house. We want to say the big boy's house. The big boy. So we've got Al-Kabir, which means the big.
Yeah.
So in order for it to be the big boy, it's got to match with?
The boy.
The boy is in what state?
Majrurun.
Therefore, Al-Kabir has to be? Majrurun. That's what's Al-Kabir.
Like the black stain.
Why? But what if we want to say the boy's big house? The boy's big house. Not the big boy's house, but the boy's big house. So, Abdul Hamid, what happens to the Ra?
You have to say that again.
So we want to now say the boy's big house.
Mm.
The boy's big house. What goes on the ra?
Link it to the word that you need.
What state is house in?
Is it marfu?
It's marfu'un.
Yeah.
Therefore, what state will Al-Kabir be in?
Same.
Which is?
Marfu'un.
Good. It's going to be Al-Kabiru. Can we see that? How it's changed? Just by changing Al-Kabiri to Al-Kabiru, you change the meaning of the sentence or the phrase in this instance. You understand?
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Should we do it again?
No, I think I got it now.
Why?
Because the Waladi, it was Kabiri.
Yes, yes. Yes, that's right. Good, mashallah. Now, why did I mention this example? Because this is an easier example of this.
I think I'm just the top of my head.
It's an easier example. So you should be thinking, just wait. Why is that an easier example? Because of this reason. It's not soda'in, although it should be, but it's not. For two reasons. It should be, and think that it is, but it's not. And for two reasons. One is that colors don't take tanweenun. They don't have two vowels on the end.
So it's
going to
be one.
Right? Because it's called, in Arabic, مَمْنُوعٌ مِنَ الصَّرَفِ, which means It doesn't change entirely. Right? You know how we've said all along that an ismun in its default state is going to be?
Marfu'un
with?
Dhamma.
Two, if it does not. Al, one if there is. That's what we've said all along, right?
Yeah.
But there's a group of words which are an exception to that rule. And they don't take tanwinun, they don't take two. Right? And in addition to that, not only do they not take two, they don't become majrur. The majrurun state is shown by a fatha. I'll say that again. There's a type of word called mamnu' min as-sarf, which actually confuses a lot of people, but it's not that difficult. What which doesn't take tanwinun, and the majrurun state is shown by a fatha. So based on that, I'm going to tell you that sawda'u is one of those words. So now Shabazz, you tell me what should be on that Hamza. I'll say it, do you want me to repeat it?
No, it should be a fatha.
Excellent, alhamdulillah. It should be a fatha.
So how do you work out one of these words?
I'll tell you.
All right.
There's colors are, right? Aswadu, black. Abiyadu, white. Azraku, blue. Ahmaru, red. Asfaru, yellow. Those colors are, in fact, it's on a particular pattern, af'alu, but we'll discuss that later. But for the time being, for those colors, the ones that I mentioned, and you can listen to it again. Those colors, those pure Arabic colors on that pattern, af'alu, they are mamnu' min as-sarf. They don't take tanween and they never become majrur.
So they can only take a fatha.
Yes. But remember, there's a principle, لِقُلِّ قَائِدَ استثناء. Every rule has an exception, and even that has an exception. But we're not going to go into this, right? The point to note is that here it's sawda'a. But remember, I mentioned this example to illustrate that it usually is like that in almost in a 99.9% of words. It will be like that. Don't think that's the norm. It's not.
This is exception.
This is the exception. But we need to know, right? Is that clear? Right, what's the next portion?
Abdul Hamid.
No point, I can't read without the
Bismillah.
Try, it's okay, you're going to improve, inshallah. Okay.
Oh, Sauda, he didn't look at you. Sauda, he stopped at Sauda.
The next portion.
Kabira.
We'll just do one more bit.
Kabira wa kana kallam.
Oh, actually, just wait. There's another word on sawda, isn't there?
Yeah.
Right.
Big hole.
Big black snake hole.
Right. So there's kabir on the end, isn't there?
Yeah.
Right.
Kabir.
Right. This is good. So this is good. This is another sifatun of what? Is it a sifatun of juhru or is it a sifatun of hayyatin?
Right,
so we have juhru hayyatin sawda'a and then kabira. So what will go on kabira?
Til Hamid.
Yeah, you said it til.
Kabira?
Ten.
Kabira ten. Why kabira ten?
has to match Hayatin.
Because it has to match Hayatin. So even though it was so da'a, we know that Kabiratin has to match Hayatin. Right?
Yeah.
We've understood that now, inshallah.
Yeah, say in English now what it means.
So, what it means from here?
No, from Wabil.
Wabil qurbi min ash-shajarati, and close by from ash-shajarati, the tree. Jihru hayyatin. A snake's hole, sawda'a, black, kabiratin, large. So a large, black snake's hole. Now remember, in Arabic, it's the opposite order to English.
Yeah.
Okay, so the way that you translate it or understand it in English, and you only do that for learning, because once inshallah you improve, you just think about it in Arabic, is a large black snake's hole.
Yeah.
But in Arabic you write it, Jihru hayyatin sawda'a kabiratin.
Hole as in hole, yeah?
Hole, as in hole in the ground.
Hole, man.
Hole. That's what happened. Hole.
How would it make sense if it was hole?
That's why I asked you to read it again. Now it makes sense. Yeah, hole. The only is a gasp to that.
Okay.
Now.
Right. So the next, we'll just do one more sentence. Or the next portion.
Just leave it here. Let's ponder
upon it. No.
No. Do you want to continue? It's up to you.
Just do one more sentence. It's only up to there. It's 4 minutes.
To number three.
Yeah.
Wakana.
Wakana.
Kullama.
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 وكان كلما
صار الغراب
صار
لي غراب
وكان كلما صار للغراب
غراب
فراخ
فراخ
No, we need there's a verb after that. Read the verb.
To eat. To eat.
Akalat.
Akalat. Ha.
Akalat. Ha. Hal.
Akalat. Ha. Al hayya. Why? Right. Kullama means whenever. Okay, whenever Sara, we've done Sara.
Just 1 moment. Can we just write the Arabic first?
Right? Yes.
Wakana.
If you could just read it and then we can write it. Wakana.
Wakana. Kullama. Sara. Lil Ghura. What should be on the bar? Lil ghura b. Why ghura b? Because it's majrurun because of. Why would. Because li is harfu jar.
Wasara
lil ghura b. Farakhun. It's going to be in its default state. It's going to be marfu'un. Farakhun. Akalat ha. Al hayya.
Two.
Right, we need to understand why. Right.
Ready.
Okay, we're ready?
Yeah.
Right. So we'll do the easy words first. Okay. Kullama means whenever.
Whenever. Yeah.
Kullama just means whenever. Sara. We've done Sara in Mishyatul Ghurab.
Sara.
فصارت مشيته أقبح مشية في الغراب. Remember, وصارت مشيته. His walk became
ugliest
walk في الطيور.
For the birds.
In the birds. So صار means
No.
Walk is mishyatun.
Yeah.
Sara means?
Ugliya.
No. That's aqbah. Sara means became.
Oh,
it's a verb. Okay, so what does it mean? This is a bit that sometimes confuses. Whenever Sara, he became, or it became, or they became, it depends what's becoming, right? Lil Ghurabi,
the rain for.
Lil Ghurabi.
The ray means for
al ghurab.
Lil is for.
Farakhun means
farakh.
Chicks.
Chicks.
Young ghurab.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's
farakhun. Right. Farakhun. Akalat ha. What we've done this before. Akalatha al-firanu.
Yeah.
So what does akalatha mean? Akalatha.
To eat.
No, exactly what does akalatha mean?
She ate. Means the snake.
Akalatha. Who's the doer? Abdul Hamid, this is your territory. Who's the al-fa'ilu here?
The one with the dhamma, the snake.
Excellent. Masha. Alhamdulillah. Al-hayyatu, the snake. Al-hayyatu akalat, ate ha.
Yes, the snake wants to get the little chicks.
Good.
Masha.
The ha refers back to? Farakhun. Okay. Akalatha al-hayyatu. So al-hayyatu akalat. Al-faraqa, the chicks. That's what happened. Okay, so we understand this bit. Akalata al-hayyatu, right? Farakhun. What does ha refer to? Farakhun, chicks. So what does all of it mean? Wa kana kullama sara lil ghurabi farakhun akalata al-hayyatu. What does it mean in a complete?
And used to.
Whenever, Abdul Hamid, tell us what does it mean? And whenever.
It doesn't flow the sentence in English. You don't have to know what double play.
Well, say it how it would flow in English.
In English, that's and used to whenever became. Sara became lil firani for raven.
Lil Ghurabi,
yeah, for raven. Chicks. I'm just doing word for word. Chicks ate snake.
Chicks ate snake.
Sorry, snake ate chicks.
So what's happened here?
Yeah. So the snake actually wants to eat the little chicks.
What's the first bit?
Not wants to. No.
Ate.
Yeah. Is doing it.
So it's happening now.
Oh, it's happening now. Eats present. Is it eats or ate that?
Ate.
Akalat
ha. She ate ha. Whoever ha refers to. So it means
whenever
there was for or lil ghurabi farakhun chicks. Akalat ha al hayyatu.
Whenever there was chicks in the snake used to eat.
Yeah.
Not complicated, right? I mean, it's not a complicated concept, but it's slightly difficult because of the use of Sara.
Yeah.
Then we have Kana.
Yeah.
Kana is used to emphasize.
Because the Kana is always to mean past.
Yes, but here, past when it's with a verb in the present, but this verb is in the past, Sara. Okay? So,
yeah.
It has in English, that has a meaning of the past perfect, i.e. something that has happened. So whenever chicks became
Yes.
For the Ghurab, meaning whenever the Ghurab had chicks,
yeah.
Farakhun, the hay al hayya to akalata, the hayya, the snake would eat them. That's what it means. But it's slightly complicated because of the way that the sentence has been structured, but it's still not beyond the realms of being understood. So that's what it means. So whenever there became four al-ghurab farakhun chicks, al-hayyatu akalata. So you can see that al-ghurabu has a problem.
Yeah.
Yes.
Big problem.
His babies keep eating. Or her babies.
That's normal. Her babies.
Okay.
I'm sitting.
Right. Any questions? Abdul Hamid, you understand, brother?
You just have to say in English the last bits. So I can write it down.
This bit?
Yeah, yeah.
So, whenever there was or there became, however you want to understand it, it's up to you.
So the way I wrote it in English was whenever a raven used to have chicks.
Not a raven, remember.
The raven used to have chicks, the snake would eat it.
Yes, yeah, the snake would eat them.
The raven.
And that would eat is where kana comes into this. Otherwise it would mean ate them. But that would eat to indicate it's an action that happened in the past, that's completed in the past, right?
What if we can say used to eat them?
Kana yakulu. Oh, actually, yeah, it would be kana takuluha. Kana. Actually, it would be kana takuluha.
Used to eat them.
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes, yeah.
Right?
First, it doesn't make sense now.
No, it does, yeah.
Any other questions?
Jazakallah
khairan, because it takes a mafulun bihi. Very important that most of our brothers they ignore the khairan, because the jaza in Arabic can give you two types, as Allah said, "Dalika jazahu jahannam bima kafaru," that their jaza is jahannam because of their disbelief. It wasn't khair, it wasn't good. So conclude on that point. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka.